With a student recently being quarantined due to COVID-19, the Hopkinton School Committee at their most recent meeting last week discussed what the procedure would be for any quarantined student receiving information and instruction for their school courses.
So how is information or instruction going to be delivered to those quarantine students who have been identified as close contacts? They're not COVID positive, they're sitting at home, and they are waiting to, you know, have some kind of instruction delivered to them. What we've told the teachers is that they have autonomy over how that information is shared or how that instruction is delivered. So the following things in that purple font are some of the choices, and we say that they can include, but they're not limited to. So a teacher can email information to a student, put things on Schoology, can offer the student a homegrown video, could offer the student a store-bought video, so there could be anything from Khan Academy to PBS. The teacher could Zoom with that student, the teacher could offer a packet for home study, or even after school, the teacher could offer telehelp. What we need to remember is that our teachers are typically available after the regular school day at 2 o'clock. So if a student wants to, you know, make that plan to Zoom with the teacher, you know, remotely at 2, that can happen as well. Our teachers are very, very willing to make sure that the kids who are in there, they're missing out on their in-person days, have some kind of direct contact with teachers, instruction, information, whatever it is that the kids will need in order to make sure that they are making effective progress while they are out. And you know, another idea might be to say, okay, if we're doing collaborative work, I mean, because we're living in a world where remote communication is just so facile, we could have our kid who's sitting at home be connected to, you know, an in-person peer, and they could work collaboratively as well. So we will try to remain as, you know, sort of vigilant, as careful, as you know, kind of being, you know, attentive and empathetic to the situation of those students who are quarantined close contacts. And I would encourage any student who is a quarantined close contact, who doesn't feel like they're getting what they need, or who feels like they are uncertain about any kind of learning, to reach out immediately to your teachers, and I know the teachers will respond.
Another topic that was discussed was physical fitness for Hopkinton Middle School students. Due to the pandemic, the middle school did cancel their fall sports program.
Okay, and then the next one, I am looking for you to approve some stipends. I think when, you'll remember when the athletic director, Mr. Cormier, was here a few weeks ago, he had talked about the fact that we wouldn't be having formal middle school sports this year. You know, there wouldn't be teams to compete against. And so one of the things that he has done, he explained to us when he was here last time, is he wants to put together these sort of cohorts of, you know, sort of strength and conditioning teams. And so in an effort to be able to do that, the stipend for that is $1,400 for one of the cohorts, and we are just looking for your approval of those stipends. Anyway, I think it's offset just by the coaching stipends that we would have had at the middle school if we had had formalized sports.
And do we have the number of enrollees?
I think it's 112 students. The last I knew it was one. Is that correct? 112.
A parent was asking me about whether this was basically only for athletes in this situation, or whether like a special needs student could maybe enroll in this program and have support during the actual program. And so I was just curious about that.
Typically when we have students with special needs who enroll in any of our athletic programs, you know, so say it's a student who has a one-to-one paraprofessional or needs support, you know, we typically provide that.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
And I think because the qualifications were very coach-oriented,
right,
it
that's
appeared, I got tripped up myself because I was thinking more maybe really like CrossFit kinds of trainers who might not be sort of MIAA coaches. And I think the qualifications were a little confusing, but I think when I asked about that, I think Dr. Kavanaugh had said that if you do happen to have coach certification, I think it's preferred, not required. It just gives you that awareness of, you know, the CPR training. There's sort of a whole bunch of stuff that goes along with that coach license that would be a good precursor to doing anything with fitness.
The cost of the program will be $75 per a student, and give the students an opportunity to participate and athletic programs with coaching.